Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Mr. TARDIS, and I was going to appear on camera for this vlog, but then my camera decided to die. After 3 years of service, it looks like I may need a new camera. It wasn't a great camera, picked up sound terribly, but it still served me well for 3 years, and it doesn't seem to be working anymore, so yay, I need a new camera. But anyway, things gone a bit downhill. But yeah, let me just keep up to date with what I've been up to recently and why there hasn't been as many Mr. TARDIS or in-depth reviews and stuff like that recently. Well, university is kind of kicking my ass at the moment. I'm doing a master's in film, and that entails a lot of work. Last semester I had to do like 2 films and like lots of stuff. But now this semester I've got to do a short film, and I'm working with some friends alongside the BBC to try and put together a test pilot for a children's show. Me working with children, let's hope that it's not going to be one of those scenarios where I have to go to the parents and be like, I'm sorry, me and the child had a disagreement and it fell down the stairs. But anyway, so I've got to do that, and as well as doing that, I'm also trying to put together a 6-part TV series, currently in negotiations to try and sort that out, and I'm also in the writing process of a feature film. So, yes, incredibly busy, but both during university and in my spare time. And as for videos, what's mainly been taking up my time is working on this Parting of the Ways review, and also doing a few bits and bobs every so often on the Trilby Reviews channel. However, YouTube has decided to screw me over yet again, after pretty much making me take down my entire 2013 awards thing. I did like 17 videos trying to do a little awards thing for the best of 2013 in film. I had to take them down. YouTube decided to screw me over there. I won't go into details because it's kind of depressing. But then afterwards, without warning, without any sort of actual reasoning, they sent me an email saying, we're going to terminate monetization on all of your channels associated with Google AdSense. So I can no longer make any advertising money on my Mr. TARDIS Reviews or my Trilby Reviews channel. Now, I'm not going to lie, I'm not exactly PewDiePie. I'm not exactly, who else is there, Total Biscuit, Angry Joe, or lots of other, critical, PewDiePie's not really critical, he just kind of screams into the microphone, but people who are able to make a living from doing YouTube. I'm not one of those people, but what I do earn from YouTube is contributing heavily towards me actually being able to pay the bills and survive and keep myself fed with a roof over my head. It's kind of actually been quite a bit of a blow, and the channel, all of my channels have actually been doing very well over the past 3 months. So to all of a sudden have YouTube just take that away with no warning, no explanation, no actual reasoning, then it's kind of a bit of a blow, both financially and also kind of mentally. The only kind of reasoning they gave was to do with copyright, but I didn't, apart from the Trilby Reviews, like the Trilby Awards stuff, which I took down, and didn't actually have any, I didn't have any strikes, it was just disputed stuff. But on my Mr. TARDIS Reviews channel, I've got 2 copyright strikes, full-on strikes, which means like 3 and I'm out, which is very depressing. Those are for Boomtown Part 2, because in one of Welshy's segments, he's having dinner with Rob, the monkey, and he's playing, I think it's Let's Get It On. He's playing some music in the background. It could barely be heard, and yet that was picked up. And and that video got blocked, and I've tried to submit a dispute for that, but apparently YouTube has a contract with said company who owns that, saying that it's Universal Music Group. They're pretty much saying that they have a contract with Universal Music Group, UMG, which means that even if I dispute a claim, they are legally obliged to ignore it. They have to keep the claim up, which and it's terrible. And the same thing for the Father's Day review, SME, Sony Music Entertainment. they have the same contract saying that, okay, I have an illegitimate copyright claim on my account. I want to dispute it. I can submit a counter notification to the company saying I am willing to go to court because that is how confident I am in the fact that I am able to use this copyrighted material in this context. But no, they are contractually obligated to ignore it. So because of the fact that I played about 10 to 15 seconds of music in a 15 minute review, no, the whole thing gets cut. I think it's a terrible, terrible system, ripe for abuse, easy to encourage censorship on the part of big music companies, and I can do nothing to fight it. I've been in contact with somebody from Sony Music Entertainment via email, because when you get a copyright strike, it says, here is the claimant email. So I've been talking to this person. I won't name names, that would be unprofessional. We're trying to come up with an agreement, although it seems like the only way to get rid of it is to delete the video, re-upload it again without the copyrighted stuff, which I think is stupid. It's a 14 minute and 55 second review of Father's Day, 10 seconds of music. Why do I have to do everything because only 14 minutes and 45 seconds isn't copyright claimed? It's stupid. And the whole one for the Boomtown, been emailing Universal Music Group, got nothing. The only thing I've heard from them was actually a couple of days ago when I emailed them for like the fourth or fifth time saying the email has been bounced back because their inbox is full. Please send it again later. Who does that? It actually kind of makes me not want to do the content, but I do because I love doing it and I know that you guys enjoy watching it. So anyway, so that's been very discouraging. Thankfully though, over the past like month, I've been doing a fundraiser. It's a website called patreon.com. It's kind of like Kickstarter, but it's for online content creators. And the best thing about it is that it's not like you give $20 for a Kickstarter and hope the project gets made. You only pay the money when the online creator creates the content. And I've got myself one of those set up. It's www.patreon.com/trilby. And basically, you can pledge certain amounts of money to get certain perks whenever a review goes online. And this isn't going to be like you pay money towards a reaction video or an update like this or a mini review or anything like that. You will only be paying for like the 15 to 30 or 40 minute in-depth reviews, as in the Doctor Who reviews. The Doctor Who reviews, the Trilby reviews, the Trilby movie reviews that are like 20 minutes long. Anything that's in-depth analysis, fully edited, fully put together, that's all you pay for. So for example, going through my latest Mr. TARDIS reviews video, Sherlock reaction, The Empty Hearse, you don't pay for. Doctor Who reaction, The Time of the Doctor, you don't pay for. It would basically be reviews like, you know, Doctor Who Bad Wolf, Doctor Who The Bells of St. John, Doctor Who review Amy's Choice, things like that, the in-depth, fully edited, fully after the fact. I've set up a campaign to try and help myself financially be able to create these videos, seeing as though YouTube has kind of cut me off. I'm going to try and get rid of as many of the copyright blocks as possible, then contact them again, telling them to stop being jerks. But as for now, it seems like Patreon is going to become even more important if I want to continue doing what I am doing while still trying to have a university education and doing all of this extra stuff. The link to the Patreon is down in the description below. While watching this, I would very much like you to click that link and I will walk you through the website just so you know exactly what's going on. So you'll be taken to the page, William Carlyle, that's me, is creating ridiculously in-depth reviews, just to emphasize that you will only be paying for the in-depth stuff. Pledge $1 or more per review, that's pretty much just like more of a donation, and that would be hugely appreciated even though it is $1. $5 or more per review, you'll get a exclusive podcast on the first day of every month, so March 1st you'll get a 1 hour or an hour and 30 minute podcast, whatever. Pretty much every single pledge you donate, you'll get everything below that as well. So $10 or more, you'll be sent a PDF of the review script. So we're talking like three or four pages of PDF script, and as well as the notes, because whenever I do a review, I write notes while watching the episode and note off specific points. You may even find a few things in the notes that weren't even in the review, so that could be a nice thing. you'll also get the podcast. $15 or more, you'll get the podcast, you'll get the PDF stuff, as well as an invite to a Google Hangout where we'll just talk, really. We'll talk for however long you want. It will be within reason. It could just be a couple of hours where we talk on a Google Hangout and get discussions going. It's literally you choose the topics, and I'll talk, we'll do whatever, we'll have discussions. $20 or more, there'll be a one-on-one half-an-hour Skype conversation with me where we can talk about anything you want. You can ask personal questions or just chat about anything. It's really up to you. $30 or more, you'll get invited to a private invitation-only Google Hangout where we'll watch the next movie or episode that or whatever that I will be reviewing. For example, if you donate by the end of the month, I will have, like, you'll have pledged towards the review of The Parting of the Ways. So what we're going to do is we're going to get together, we're going to watch Kick-Ass the movie, which will be a Chubby Reviews movie review. So we'll be watching Kick-Ass all together live at the same time. We can do a fan commentary, we can discuss the pros and cons, we can discuss the movie while we're watching it, or you can just sit back, don't contribute at all, and just watch the fun unfold. It's really up to you. Like I said, it's what you make of it. $35 or more, then I will also send you a laminated print of the title card of said review. If you donate by February 27th or 28th, like pretty much before the end of February, then you'll get a Parting of the Ways title card. Signed by me, a laminated high quality print, because that will be the review that you help to pledge, because yes, the next review will be The Parting of the Ways. $50 or more, you'll get all of the above, but you also get to request the review. You'll get to request a review that I do in future. And also, if you want to be in the review and share your opinions on it, then you can do that. Or if you don't feel like appearing on camera, or you don't want your voice to be heard, like literally your voice, then that's fine. That's up to you completely. But you can give me like a paragraph or two, and I will relay your message or your thoughts on the movie to the viewers on your behalf. So if you really like a movie, or if you have something really... I have a personal story with the movie, or if there's something that you've noticed about the film or episode or whatever that you don't think anybody else has and would like me to tell people, then you can do just that. Although one of those perks has been taken at time of recording, so there's only one of those left. Technically three, because there's still one more perk, and like I said, every perk you get everything underneath that as well. That's the $80 perk, which is one for really... awesome people who like to donate that much to me, and for aspiring filmmakers, as I will look over your script or pre-production work on a film project you want to get made, and I will give you my pre-production thoughts. I'll give you honest critique, I'll give you constructive feedback to try and help your film become the best it really can. And even if you've got like a short film or something that you've made as a hobby or as a university film or something, or you've got a draft or a rough cut of a film, then yeah, send it my way, and I will take a look at it and just try and make it the best that it can be, because kind of like as a part-time job, I'm also kind of a script consultant for quite a few people. So I've been doing that to earn a little bit of extra money in the light of this whole YouTube thing. But yeah, but if you get that, you'll also get everything before that. The review request, the title card, the commentary, the Skype conversation, the Google Hangout, the PDF script, the podcast, and the fact that you've helped contribute towards MrTARDIS's stuff. So yeah, it's a lot of stuff. That sounds like a lot of information, but I'm trying to make this as easy as possible for people. I'm not saying that if you don't donate, there is no more MrTARDIS. That is not the case at all. I would endeavour to try and continue creating this content, but that YouTube are continually making it harder and harder to do so. So things like Patreon and you guys will become even more important than ever in order to do this. And it's not like you're getting your paying money for just the reviews. You're also getting all of these perks, which should be a lot of fun. I really look forward to being able to interact with you more on the Skype conversations, the Google Hangouts, and etc. Like I said, if you're able to donate by the end of the month, because you will be getting the Parting of the Ways review by the end of February. I'm working on it right now. I'm pretty much like halfway through, and in all of my spare moments, I'm working on it. I've also done a few mini reviews on my Trilby Reviews channel of Mr. Peabody and Sherman and RoboCop, and you'll be getting one soon for the Lego movie. So yes, thank you very much for watching this video. I'd hugely appreciate any and all support via Patreon. And if you have any questions about the website or about any of the perks, then please sound off in the comments section below. Thank you very much for listening, and I shall see you guys next time for the Parting of the Ways review.